you know, the people that just all the fighting over the years. And it was very historic.
Yeah, indeed it was. And so a new school district name. I'm listening to Rick Harper this morning on our news as he talked about what went into that decision. The decision-making process, how difficult was that?
You know, we really wanted to give the opportunity to our students to be involved. And that's what was probably the most special thing about the culmination of the decision. You know, we obviously had a number of different surveys, and this was K to 12 as well. So we even had, we were waiting on the final number, final things for the colors. We even had paper ballots coming from kindergarten. It's kind of like, and I asked our staff person, I'm like, how does it look? She goes, it's like, it's 2020 or 2016 all over again. It's very close. Okay. But you know, yeah, it was, it went, the students being involved made this thing really, it's what it's all about.
Yeah, yeah. The input, of course, has to come from a number of different people when you make historic decisions such as was made last night. And then that doesn't mean that everything is final. There's still a regulatory process to go through, isn't there?
There is. Even the last night, I'm working with our technology director, just simply looking to lock down a domain name for our new, you know, which will be our new internet login and our email. But there's a huge logistical part of this. Obviously, we have to work with the state, which we were going to be doing anyways. And then obviously, as you said, you know, working with the banking and people like that. So those are hurdles we'll get over, but we feel it's well worth the decision that was made.
Well, speaking of working with the state, obviously there's still a lot of work to be done in order to make this all happen. How is the process going?
The process is going very well. You know, we've had discussions with the Commonwealth. We followed all the guidelines we had to do, you know, with the process we put in place. So we're moving full forward with our transition. We do have a lot of transitional information on our website, which includes a timeline, you know, some of the things we're looking at. You know, we're looking at transitioning students and staff here within the next, obviously, few weeks. We have plenty of room on the Blairsville campus. We have plenty of lockers. I guess what's really great about this year, too, we are, you know, our number of course offerings, we've increased by 23 to 30. So the opportunities our students are going to have, because we now have equity and balance, you know, in this school district, as far as what we're doing from an academic perspective, I think it'll be an incredible opportunity for our students.
Yeah, well, there's still all of that work that has to be done over the summertime. And when I spoke with you last, we were talking about examining the bus routes that would be taken. How is that whole process going along? I would guess that that's a very complicated one.
It is complicated, but, you know, like I said, we listened to, you know, some of the concerns of parents. You know, but we've had numerous, you know, studies done looking at different routes. And the bus, we're working very close to Smith Bus now to do that, to give our board all the options. But obviously what we want to do is to assure that bus route is the safest bus route, but also is the shortest bus route that we can create. And that's what we're working very hard to do, because we did listen to those concerns. You know, some of them, I mean, these bus routes will not be over an hour. As we portrayed during the 780 hearing, we're working to minimize that. And, you know, my goal is to keep every bus run under 45 minutes in this district, which is reasonable for the sheer size of it, no matter. And that includes Blairsville students as well. I mean, it's both sides. So that's the thing. So we're working very hard to find that best solution, which we'll be able to do and present to our board for the June meeting.
At the baseball game the other night, a parent from the Saltsburg end of the district came up to me and said to me, and this, I asked this question only because it points out how there are so many details that have to be covered. Their question was, how are we going to play in that horrible football stadium, as they called it, in Blairsville? Tell me about athletic facilities, and then let's talk generally about having all of these details that have to be taken care of in what is a relatively short period of time.
You know, we are looking, we knew as part of, as we looked at the whole grand plan of things, that we were going to have to make some upgrades to our facilities. So we are exploring numerous opportunities at potential sites. You know, obviously it'll take some time to develop that, but that would even include a renovation of the Blairsville, you know, site football stadium with a track, or maybe locating a separate athletic facility in between both campuses if possible, if we can find a piece of land. So really, as we get through and after we start school in the fall, that's what the board will start to embark on and investigate, because athletics is important to both sides of the school district. That is one thing that was a common denominator throughout this whole process, Todd, which I think it also be the same reason to bring people together, as that parent just said that to you. Both stadiums needed a lot of work, to be quite honest with you, regardless of if it was Saltsburg or Blairsville. But the board knows that that's a priority, to try to upgrade some of these facilities. You know, this district has been very good over the years for not incurring a lot of debt. So we have opportunities financially that we can explore, especially with the, you know, as of now, with rates being low and that. So we're going to be looking at all those things in the near future.
Yeah. And my disclaimer is I didn't call it horrible. They did.
Just no,
making that clear. Details. As I said a couple of moments ago, there are so many small details that can become big if they're not handled correctly and in a timely manner. And I know that you're working very hard on that. Yes.
Yes, and that's why as we continually update, last night I walked the school board, and we'll have on our website today just a diagram of the building and show them exactly. We'll have, you know, the current 40 classrooms we'll be using, but the 10 new ones. But every teacher, you know, outside of art and shop will have their own classroom. Students will fit comfortably. We'll make parents aware of this. And, you know, as we move forward through the summer, we're going to look to have, you know, an event to bring the students together where it actually simulates a school day, and their parents will be involved as well to show them everything from the bus ride, the day at school, to what the lunch will look like, and so forth. So that is the culmination of all this, you know, at the end of all this transition and planning.
I don't guess that there's much that you can say because this is a legal issue, but I have to ask it anyway. Any response to the lawsuit that was filed against the district?
You know, we feel very, very good where we're at from a legal perspective, but that being said, I leave the lawyers do their thing and I just do mine, and we're moving ahead full tilt.
All right. Very good. Anything else that folks need to know about this transition? You did mention that there's so much material on the school district website and folks can find a lot of information there. But what are the things that you think folks need to know right now today?
I think they just need to understand that we do have a process in place, you know, to create these plans, these transition plans. But if there is an uncertainty, or they hear something that, you know, that sounds, you know, like even just like what you mentioned about the question, like, this, well, where are we going to be doing these types of things? I urge them to call my office, or call their building principal, you know, Mr. Laser, our high school principal. But reach out and get the answer that they're looking for without it festering into, you know, and then getting into rumors and different things. So we're here to be open and answer those questions for the community, and that's our priority.
And is there any chance I can get Space Pirates as the team name?
Space Pirates. Well, we may be able to do that with one of the elementary schools. They'd probably like that.
I would not be good at that whole process. Philip Martell, thank you so much for being with us this morning. Appreciate it.
All right. Take care.
You too. It is the voice of Indiana County, WCCS 101.1 FM, AM 1160.